Hello, this is Julia Bushkova, and today I'm going to briefly illuminate the Russian bow hold issue. The Russian bow hold is known in the West only, not in Russia. And me being now the violinist of both worlds, so to speak, I grew up in Russia, got education in there, and now, of course, I have been in the United States actually longer than I was in Russia. I can definitely tell you that the Russian bow hold is not exactly Russian. So what we call in the United States the Russian bow hold, or some people make a nice definition at least, and they say the old Russian bow hold, is when the bow is held, the index finger rather, is placed on the bow between the middle and the base joint. So placing the middle finger there will result in certain adjustments or pronation of your forearm, and usually we see this as the result. So another, what is this? This is that bit when you are by the tip of the bow, all the fingers are pretty much straight. Sometimes the pinky or even third finger, ring finger, completely leave the bow, depending on how much you pronate, or rather over pronate, you have to. Another also feature of this bow hold is that when we go to the frog, we don't usually have a lot of cushion motion, or some people say not at all, and make the change with the help of the arm, upper arm and the forearm, rather, and a little bit, most people still do something with the fingers, but not much at all. So these, in a nutshell, are features of what is called Russian and old Russian bow hold, or old Russian bow hold. What's the problem with it? Why am I making a video? Well, simply because it is not true. What is not true is that not all of Russia at all, or most of Russia rather, doesn't play with a Russian bow hold. In Russia, it has been the Franco-Belgian bow hold that has been the most prevalent over the course of history of playing the instrument. However, the person who made the so-called Russian or Old Russian bow hold so popular in the West was Leopold Auer. And Leopold Auer, as we all know, was a teacher of extremely famous violinists like Heifetz, like Elman, like Zimbalist, Milstein went through him, and so on and so forth. Many people. Auer himself... Yeah, in his method, he describes putting the bow something like that. Actually, he describes it better than he held it himself. He holds the bow like this, if you look at the pictures. And Leopold Auer, he was Hungarian. The fact that he taught in Russia for a prolonged period of time is true. How many of his students actually kept teaching in Russia and propagating his method, his so-called method? Not many at all. So the most prevalent bow hold in Russia is the Franco-Belgian, which is, as everybody knows, when we place the index finger on the stick between the nail joint and the middle joint, and then we have the rounded hand, especially at the frog. We use our wrist and fingers to make a good connecting movement, which we call the bow change at the frog. And so on and so forth. I will not go into the Franco-Belgian hold right now. It's very well known. So growing up in Russia, that's the only bow hold I knew of. I knew it from what I've observed, from the concerts that I went to, and everything around. Never anyone was displaying the what is called here Russian bow hold. I propose so that we would change to call this bow hold as the Leopold Auer bow hold, or Heifetz bow hold, or maybe Misha Elman bow hold. But it is certainly has nothing to do with the prevalence of this type of hold in Russia or coming from Russia. Maybe it should be called Hungarian bow hold.